Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The issue about zakat I want to cover in this session is zakat on partnerships. Essentially, the only difference of a partnership is just like a partnership would be a partnership in a business, I'm assuming. So everything relevant to zakat on businesses is going to relate to zakat on partnership. The only difference is going to be that whatever the proportionate share of each partner is, they will be liable for that amount of assets within the company, whatever is zakatable of that proportion, they will be liable for that. So the way some companies work is that they may be limited companies, and which in the legal terms be considered an independent entity, right? And even though it's got two owners and so on, two directors and so on and so forth. However, in essence, if that is to be dissolved, then obviously that money will go to those shareholders and to those partners anyway. So the liability of the assets in there do belong to the shareholders. That means they are liable for the zakat in that. So what happens is, just say that somebody's paying their personal zakat in Ramadan. So they're going to incorporate in there any dividend that they may have received. So if Ramadan is in May and they got a dividend in April, right? So basically that means they've already got that before the date of their zakat. That means they're going to include that in there if they've still got any money left from that. However, any monies which are left inside and any other zakatable assets that are inside the business, who takes care of that? So really what happens then is, the way you should do this is that you should basically decide whose is what. You will know that from the shareholding. And then that would be divided, and the value of that will be ascertained, whatever is zakatable and whatever is not zakatable. So whatever is zakatable, even though you're not pulling it out as a dividend, right, you've got stock, inventory, or other things which are zakatable, or other cash that you've just kept in there, right, that is going to be divided among the shareholders, and they will then pay zakat on that on their zakat date as well. So I got a question recently that there's a partnership in a company. Two people are partners, 50-50, let's just say, and their company accounts are made 6 months after Ramadan. So do they have to wait until 6 months later and then pay zakat on that day on behalf of the company separately? So as I mentioned, the company is not due to pay any zakat on its own. There's no liability on a company because we don't see companies as independent entities. They belong to the owners. So really what you should be doing is you should get them to make a calculation of the zakatable assets around the time that you are paying zakat, so on the day that is your zakat date that you fixed, right? And whatever's in there at that time is what you'll pay zakat on, right? That is what's important. You don't wait until the company has to do its own accounts. Of course, when the company does its accounts, then sometimes there's certain things which become more clearer in terms of what's owed and what's what they're holding and so on. Then you can actually go back then and just check if you've paid sufficiently, right? So you can use that to correct any wrong. And if you've paid more from before, well, that's fine, it becomes sadaqah, right? And if you've paid less, then you'll have to pay that much. But otherwise, you generally don't wait until the company's accounts become due, and you don't have to pay on behalf of the company. Yes, if somebody wants, if there's two partners, and on the day that their zakats are due, they can actually pay whatever the assets are in the business that are zakatable, they can just pay on those assets without distributing them among them. That's completely fine, because the maximum that will cause is that maybe somebody will pay more zakat than they're supposed to. And that's fine. In that case, you hardly will ever pay zakat less than what's due. So you can do it like that as well on the day that the individual's zakats are due. So hopefully that's clear, inshallah.